So, what are my thoughts on Pirates of the Caribbean on Stranger Tide? Stay tuned. So I'm coming back with another film review of the Pirates saga. I wouldn't even say trilogy now. Pirates of the Caribbean on Stranger Tides. So, Pirates of the Caribbean on Stranger Tides, I remember when they talked about making this film, they said Keira Knightley wasn't going to be in it, Orlando Bloom wasn't going to be in it, and I was just like, okay, and Johnny Depp's going to be in it, but not them. And at that point, I was just kind of like, why am I watching this film? Like, I understand people like to say, well, Johnny Depp, but I'm like, yeah, but as a film goer, Johnny Depp is a strong actor. He's a wonderful actor and he can hold a film. But Captain Jack Sparrow is not good enough on his own, for my taste. I don't feel you can just do a Jack Sparrow film with just him and not have strong cast around him. And lo and behold, that's what we got. And that's not discredit to any of the actors. It's just that's a discredit to, or that's just saying the characters just weren't as strong or as likable as Will Turner, Elizabeth Swann. That's just the reality. They weren't. Besides Geoffrey Rush, I mean, Barbossa. But that's that. And even still, he can only do so much too. You got him and Jack Sparrow. And then what else do you have? You know, you have Gibbs, but even Gibbs is not as strong as Will Turner, Elizabeth Swann. He's just not. That's not his character. And again, not knocking any of the actors in this film. Just stating how the characters are. And what makes the Pirates film work? It's those three characters, actually those four: Barbossa, Jack Sparrow, Elizabeth Swann, and Will Turner. At least from the way I've seen the films, how they did so well. So with this film, it is a continuation. It's not a reboot. It's picking up probably, I'd say, 1 or 2 years after 3. And Jack is going for the Fountain of Youth because they alluded to that at the end of 3. And of course, you know, he's in England. It was cool to see that part. You know, he's in England and he's talking with the king and that whole thing. And then, of course, we see Barbossa come in, who's done a total metamorphosis of character. But of course, it's a show. That's not really who he is. There's a reason behind it. And of course, he's missing his leg. And he's like, what happened? What happened to the Black Pearl? And all these things. And then we bring in, shoot, and I'm sorry, I forget her name. She's a great actress too. Penelope Cruz. We bring her in as Angelica. She's supposed to be Captain Jack Sparrow's former girlfriend or something. But I'm like, didn't this dude kind of have multiple girlfriends? What sets her apart from anybody else? At least that's how I felt when I watched it. And of course, you find out that's the main villain, or the villain of this film. There is no other villain. Is Blackbeard, played by Ian McShane. Same Ian McShane, which is in the John Wick films. The Walter, the guy who runs the Continental, that guy. And, you know, it's kind of an adventure film. It has some action. But overall, it was a forgettable film. It wasn't memorable. And the reason why I think it wasn't memorable, it wasn't because of Johnny Depp. I think the issue with the film was it was missing Will Turner and Elizabeth Turner, because eventually they became husband and wife. It was missing that element of them. But also the fact that, and it was Blackbeard. You know, Blackbeard actually was a real pirate. And he was menacing, he was very dangerous, and he didn't play. And there's a history of him killing people. And of course, this is a Disney film, we can't just show people getting killed. We can, you know, it just kind of felt like, you guys, when you did Barbossa, the first one, he was menacing. Even Davy Jones and Beckett were menacing, evil, you know? But when you did Blackbeard, they would say, oh, he's evil, he's this. They would say, make comments about him in the film, but I'm just like, okay, I'm not seeing what it is that makes him worse than Davy Jones or Beckett or Barbossa. I felt like Blackbeard, how they made Blackbeard was down here, and everybody from the other villains and the other films were up here. Blackbeard was just kind of like, and it's not because of the actor, it's because of the script. He just was like, whatever, dude. Like, he wasn't, there was nothing that made you kind of fear him. I mean, people could say, whoa, he did this with the sword. I'm like, so what? Like, it's not necessarily always his actions, it's his tone. It's what he does. And he really didn't do much. And then them racing for the Fountain of Youth, I was just kind of like, I don't know if that probably would have been the best story to run with. I don't know. The film felt kind of rushed. It felt like going through the motions to an extent. I mean, there were elements of it that were entertaining. It was cool. But overall, it was just like, it was a forgettable film. My rating for the film, I would get 3 out of 5 yes sirs. And I'm only giving it 3. I really could have gotten a 2, is because two things. Captain Jack Sparrow and Barbossa. That's it. That was the only redeeming quality about this film. Because everybody else was pretty much, they were just forgettable. And again, I'm not into bashing or talking bad about actors or actresses. I don't care about that. I care about character development, and I care about characters. And I felt like the characters were just like, whatever. They, you know, Angelica was like, whatever. Blackbeard was a disappointment. The whole story just wasn't very good. It was just like, eh, whatever. Like, I didn't go see this in the theater. I think when I found out that it wasn't going to have Orlando Bloom and Keira Knightley, I think I was turned off, where I was like, I don't think I'm going to go see this in theaters. And again, Johnny Depp can pull numbers. It was just like a whatever type of film. I was like, what are you going to do that's going to keep me interested after doing 1, 2, and 3? Because 1, 2, and 3 were just like, boom. You know, they were great. Some people may not have liked them as much, but I loved them. And there wasn't anything in 4 that made me want to spend the money to go see it in theaters. I waited until it came out on DVD, and I was going to buy it. I already knew I was going to buy it because I'm a fan, but I knew I wasn't going to go see it in theaters and then buy it on DVD or Blu-ray. I think it was DVD at the time. I don't think Blu-ray was really hitting it like that yet. Because I have it on DVD. Or Blu-ray was, but I wasn't spending money on it yet. So, you know, I would say if you're a fan of Pirates, watch it, and that's it. It's entertaining, but it's not great. Honestly, if it was just Johnny Depp in here and all new cast, I probably would have given this film like a 2, maybe a 1.5. It's just not a great film. It's not the worst thing. In my ranking for the Pirates film, I do put it at the bottom. But it's more so, it's just entertaining if you're a fan. If you've never seen the Pirates films, I wouldn't advise to watch it. It is what it is. So with that being said, I will catch you guys on the next one. Take care.